If you like my content, please like and click on the subscribe button. Click on the drop-down and select all to see regular updates.
Greetings everyone. Welcome back to my channel, Data Sculptor. Today, we are going to see another important scenario in Power BI. So, to explain this, I have taken the AdventureWorks database in the Power BI. So here, what we are trying to solve is, we are trying to solve the columns ordering in a particular matrix. So here we have a matrix visual, and here if you see, you have the three columns: total extended amount, total unit price, and total sales amount. So here we are having a requirement. Say the customer wants to view these particular measures in the order which he wants. So here, one of the customer wants to see the total extended amount first, the total unit price second, and the total sales amount third. So that is why it is like this. So tomorrow, some other person will ask, so I just want to see the total sales amount first, then the total extended amount, and then the total unit price. So based on the ordering here, so if you see the first, under one, you have these three measures, under two, you have these three measures, and under three, you have these three measures. So based on the ordering, the measure should be visible in the matrix. So this is the requirement. So now let's see how to achieve this in Power BI. So to first achieve this scenario, let's create three measures called total sales, which is nothing but sum of sales of sales amount, total unit price is nothing but sum of sales of unit price, and total extended amount, sum of sales of extended amount. Okay, and I have dragged this in a particular in a matrix. Okay, I have dragged this in a matrix, and if you see, even if I change this particular ordering, it will not work. Okay, because I have created this. Okay, before this, I need to create one more table called order measure. So order measure, you need to create in such a way that you need to populate this measure in these three values, because there are three measures. So you need to populate with this 1, 2, and 3. So basically the schema of this order measure table is, you need to create two columns called order and measure, and in measure you need to write the three measures which you want to change the order. Okay, so the first is total sales amount, the next is total unit price, and the next is total extended amount. Okay, and these three measures, you need to assign all the orders. Okay, you need to assign order 1, order 2, and order 3. Why only three orders are there? Because you have only three measures. Suppose if you have tomorrow another measure, you will have to populate order 4 as well. Okay, so basically you need to create this table with this format, order and measure. Okay, it's not necessary that you need to create it using data table only. You can create it anyway. You can create it either using summarize or anything as per your needs. You can also create in an underlying SQL server also, from where you are pulling the table, anywhere you can get, but just that you need to make sure that you need to have this table in this required format. Okay, so now what I'll do, I have created this slicer and I have dragged this order and measure. So but if you see, this particular slicer is not getting interacted with this these three measures. So first, what we need to make sure that we need to enable this interaction between this matrix and this particular slicer. So for that, we will create a new measure. Okay, so I'll rename this measure called switch measure. Okay, I'll keep this switch measure. Okay, so what I'll do is, first I'll create a variable A, and I'll take the selected value of this particular order measure. Okay, so whatever value is selected in this, I'll make sure that is captured in this variable A. After it is captured, what I'll do, I'll return switch off. We all know what a switch function does. Returns different results depending on the value of an expression. So based on the expression, which is A, and if the value is returning total sales amount, okay, the measure should be total sales. Okay, and next, if it is total unit price, it should be total unit price. If it is total extended amount, then it should be total extended amount. Okay, so you need to make sure that whatever value you write here, that should exactly match with the value which is present in the measure column. Okay, and now if you click on commit, this measure will be created, and you will, let's drag this measure and let's use this measure in the matrix. Let's keep this in the values, and this measure column, let's keep it in the columns. Okay, So if you see here, I selected first the total extended amount, you are getting a total extended amount, then the total sales amount, you are getting the total sales, and then the unit price, you are getting total unit price. If you see here, based on the order I have selected, it is coming. But if I change the order, say total sales amount, next if I keep total extended, and then next if I keep total unit price, it is not coming. The order is different. But based on the selection in the order, I need to get this output. So in this particular selection, I need to get the first I need to get the total sales amount, then the total extended amount, and then the total unit price. So before we solve this, let's cover another function called REPT. Okay, I have created this measure called test, and here I have created this REPT with UniCare. Okay, before this, let's keep a star. Okay, and let's understand what this REPT returns. Okay, so now I'll drag this as a card here. So if you see this test measure, I'm returning a star. And I am returning it only once because I have written it one here. Suppose if I write 5 here, this will return 5 stars. Okay. So this REPT is nothing but repeating. Just understand it as repetition. Okay. So you need to repeat this particular string these many number of times. Okay. So you need to return the star 5 times. So that's why it is returning 5 stars. And if I keep it here 10, it will return me 10 stars. Okay, so that is what REPT means. So now what we will do is, in this particular switch measure, I will make sure that I will concatenate a blank character or a hidden character over here. So the hidden character with zero with space, I will add it here. So how will I do concatenate of? So I'll REPT, and so the blank character is UniCare of 8203. Okay, so I will repeat this how many times? I'll repeat this the order time. So the whatever is the order, suppose if the order is 1, I'll repeat this one time. So how do I do? Max of order measure of order. Okay, and this repeat I will close, and I'll close this concatenate. Okay, so basically what I'm trying to do here is, I am making sure that I will append, suppose here if I am selecting total sales amount as the first value, right? So this one, I will append one hidden character before the sales. Okay, so whatever is the value of the sales amount, before this value 109, I will append a single hidden character. And again, I will just copy this entire thing, and I will add it to every measure. Total unit price as well. And total extended amount also. Okay, so what I am trying to do is, I am trying to append, so for this in this example, the total sales amount, so under 1 I have selected total sales amount, so total sales amount should come first, right? So what happened, before 109 I have appended one hidden character, and under and total extended amount before this 1103, I have appended two hidden characters, and before total, in the total unit price, before this value, I have appended three unit characters. Okay, so now let's try to understand a simple simple text. Okay, simple ascending order and descending order, let's try to understand. So AAA comma ABC, so if you keep this in ascending order or descending order, how will it come? Okay, so AAA value is less than the ABC. Okay, so what I will try to do here is, so here I will keep it in descending order. Okay, what happened now? Total sales amount is coming first because I have added the hidden characters at the first, right? So total sales amount will come first, and then the total extended amount, and then the total unit price. Okay, and now if I select total unit price first, the total sales amount in the second, and total extended amount at the third. This will come in this way, and again if I change it, total sales amount, total extended amount, and total unit price, this will come in this way. So in this way we need to achieve this particular scenario. So based on the select ordering, you need to return the columns order based on the selection value. So hope you all understood this explanation, and if you like this, please click on the like button and also click on subscribe button for more videos. Thank you. Have a nice day.